Welcome all. Today, we are going to learn about the duties of a registered medical practitioner in cases of injuries and also how to write a wound certificate or injury certificate. The first and foremost duty of the medical officer is to treat the patient and not allow him to die of injuries. In order to do so, the patient should be examined throughout the day without any delay. And we should not wait for the police formalities to complete. And if the case is medically legal, and this is not a bar for starting the treatment, even the case is medically legal or not, we should not delay the treatment. And if the patient is not in a condition to give a consent, and there is nobody with the patient to give consent, we have to treat after consulting a colleague. In a landmark judgment by the Supreme Court in 1989, even a general practitioner has to treat every case of injury and vehicular accident. In case sufficient treatments are not available, he can just provide first aid and refer to the patient to a better center. Refusing to give treatment is considered as an evidence of negligence and may even amount to being a party to the crime also. And if the patient is to be referred to a higher center, please send the patient along with the detailed records. And if the patient is brought dead, we should not issue death certificate, but we have to inform the police and send the body for inquest and postmortem examination. Second duty is about a second opinion, and we should always consult a colleague while treating a case of homicidal injury or medico-legal cases. Third is to collect preliminary data. We should always note the reference number and date of requisition sent by the investigating officer. We have to record all the preliminary data like name, age, sex, address, brought by, brought from, brought at the time and date, time and place of examination, the consent, and two marks of identification. These are all the preliminary data that have to be collected. Next, we have to look into the details of the history. So not about the weapon used or the vehicle involved. If it is a road traffic accident, then the name of the assailant, time and type of injuries, treatment received, and the history of drug allergy, if any. Next, we have to go for the investigations. And if we suspect a bony injury, a radiological examination should be done. And in case of head injury, we should opt for ophthalmoscopy to diagnose any case of raised intracranial pressure. If we fail to do a radiological examination or ophthalmoscopy, it is itself an evidence of medical negligence. If we suspect internal injuries, it can be investigated by ultrasonogram and CT scan, or MRI can be done. And all the reports of these investigations should be preserved. Next is to inform the police about the injury. In case of injury, if the injuries are of homicidal, suicidal, or vehicular accident, we have to inform the police station. In case of public hospital or government hospital, all injury cases should be informed to the police. And in all cases, if the patient turns serious or the patient is about to die, we have to inform police. And if the patient is likely to die, we have to arrange for recording dying declaration. And if sufficient time is not there to wait for the magistrate to arrive, the doctor should himself record the dying declaration. And if the patient dies, do not issue death certificate, but we have to inform police and send the body for postmortem examination. In all cases, a detailed record of injuries, history, complaints, reports of examination, investigations, prognosis, and treatment should be maintained. Ideally, the injuries should be photographed or sketches should be prepared at the time of examination. All the details of the incident should be entered in an accident register. We have to maintain professional secrecy about the information collected from the patient. And lastly, we have to prepare an injury report. And if the injuries are not immediately visible, example, in case of deep contusions or visceral injuries, we have to observe the patient for 2 to 3 days before preparing the injury report. Or if the injury report were given prima facie, we can give an additional report after examining the patient in 2 to 3 days. Now about issuing a wound certificate. The casualty medical officer or any other medical officer who examines the injured person is the one who is in charge of filling up the wound certificate. And in all cases of medical legal injuries, they should be examined without any delay at any time, day or night. And all the details of the examination of the injured person, whether he is admitted in hospital or treated in or outpatient, must be entered in the accident register that is kept in every government hospital, which is a confidential record, and this should be kept in safe custody. If asked by the court of law, it must be produced to the court of law. Then a detailed and accurate recording should be done by the doctor. We have to sign each and every corrections. And preferably, we should fill in a printed form of injury or wound certificate. 2 copies are to be made. 1 copy should be sent to the investigating officer in a sealed cover, and the other should be kept for future reference. And if the injured person is brought to the hospital, the doctor should inform the police station over telephone or by a letter of intimation. Preliminary particulars like serial number, name, age, and sex of the injured person and address, father's or guardian's name, date and time and place of examination, name and number of accompanying police constable and police station to which he belongs, name of persons who had accompanied the injured person with their address, brief statement by the injured person about the exact nature of the accident, where it took place, time and date of incident, details of physical force used in assault, 2 identification marks, size of the victim, about the stature, body weight, and development. Then the consent of the person should be taken before examination. And if the patient is in a serious condition, we have to record dying declaration. Now about the various entries that are to be filled in a wound certificate, the nature of each injury, size, shape, and direction of each injury, on which part of the body inflicted, a simple, grievous, or dangerous injury, by what weapon inflicted, whether the weapon was dangerous or not, and finally the remarks. First point, the nature of each injury. So whether the injury is an abrasion, contusion, incised wound, lacerated wound, or firearm wound should be noted. And multiple injuries present may be grouped according to their kind and severity. We can use a lens to get the naturally accurate idea about the nature of the edges, about the ends and flows of a wound. If there is any foreign material present in the wound, example like metal, glass, splinter of wood, broken point of a knife, pellet, bullet, wad of firearm, hair, dirt, etc., it should be mentioned. And these foreign materials should be noted, reserved, and handed over to the police. We can take photographs, which should be useful in the future. Then position of injuries may be shown in a body sketch. Second point is size, shape, and direction of each injury. So all the injuries should be measured, and we should never do a guesswork. And the amount of blood extravasated should be measured. Then photographs or sketches showing the position and size of wounds is also a desirable thing to do. And shape of the wound should be noted, also the beveling of edges. Direction of the wound should be noted with respect to the anatomical position of the body. In stab and bullet injuries, direction of the wound should be noted. And pattern of wound, etc., should also be noted. Third point is on what part of the body inflicted. The exact situation of the wound with respect to some anatomical landmark like the midline, a bony structure, a joint, the navel, or the nipple should be mentioned. As far as possible, the technical terms should be avoided, as these injury certificate, if it is a medical legal case, should be dealt in a court by the judges and the advocates. So as far as possible, technical terms should be avoided. And photographs are also useful to support our opinion. The position of the injuries can also be shown on a body sketch. The fourth point is whether the injury is a simple injury, grievous injury, or a dangerous injury. So against each injury numbered, it should be noted whether it is simple, grievous, or dangerous. And if the nature of injury cannot be made out at the time of examination, the injured person must be kept under observation. And if we suspect a fracture, an X-ray examination should be done for confirming the presence of fracture. In such cases, the report should not be given hastily if there is pressure from the police. So we have to wait till the investigation report comes. So a little about a dangerous injury, and these are included and are a type of grievous injury. And dangerous injury is defined as an injury which endangers life, that is, which is dangerous to life. And therefore, dangerous injuries can be fatal if surgical intervention is not done. And it is not sufficient that the injury involves a vital organ. Actually, it should endanger life. Some examples of dangerous injury are firearm injuries, comminuted fracture of skull, depressed fracture of skull, comminuted fracture of multiple bones, stab wound into a body cavity, cutthroat wound, chop wounds, gross injury to vital organs, rupture of internal viscera, and injury to major blood vessels. The fifth point to be noted is by what weapon inflicted. So we have to examine the wound and clothes to get definite information about the weapon. Stab and incised wounds may be simulated by injury with broken glass. And wounds made by blunt instruments, blows, or kicks over bony prominences may simulate incised open. And sometimes a medical officer may be shown a weapon and asked were the wounds caused by this weapon. And if it is asked by the police, we should never answer it in the direct affirmative, but should state that the wounds could be caused by the weapon or were caused by a similar weapon. Sometimes police will send weapons for examination. And if so, we have to examine the weapon for any blood stains, hair, piece of cloth, etc. And it should be returned to the police after it is sealed. Stabbing instrument is likely to break when it passes through the sternum or skull or enters a vertebra. And sometimes a broken part may remain within the body that can be collected during examination. Any foreign body found in the body should be preserved and sent to the investigating officer. The presence of dust, coal, grease, etc. should be noted, and they might give a clue to the nature of injury. The clothes should be examined for the presence of tears, cuts, or burns, and it should be seen if these injuries correspond to the injury on the body. And if the clothing is very loose and was disarranged during the struggle or folded on itself, they may not coincide with the wounds. So this point is to be kept in our mind. Weapons are usually classified as hard and blunt objects, sharp-edged weapons, sharp-pointed weapons, sharp-edged, sharp-pointed weapons, and firearm weapons. Hard and blunt objects may cause abrasions, contusions, or lacerations. And hard and blunt objects may be rough or smooth, and may be heavy or light. If it is rough, hard, blunt, and rough, it may cause abrasion. If it is hard, blunt, and smooth, it may cause contusions or lacerations. If it is hard, blunt, and heavy, it causes lacerations. And hard, blunt, and light causes abrasions or contusions. Sharp-edged weapons may be single sharp-edged or double sharp-edged, or it can be a heavy weapon which causes incised or chop wounds, or can be a light weapon causing incised wound. Sharp-pointed weapons cause stab wounds, and sharp-edged, sharp-pointed weapons cause incised or stab wounds. As you will know, firearm weapons cause firearm injuries. These are the type of weapons. So we have to find out which weapon inflicted the injury. Next point is whether the weapon is dangerous or not. So a dangerous weapon is any instrument that is used for shooting, stabbing, or cutting, or any instrument which is used as a weapon of offense, which is likely to cause death. As per section 324 and 326 IPC, following are the dangerous weapons, objects for shooting, stabbing, or cutting. Any object or instrument which, when used, is likely to cause death, and bomb explosions, corrosives, fires, and animals. This section 324 is beautifully explained in the film Action Hero Biju. Lastly, about the remarks. The general condition of the patient should be noted in the injury certificate, and the age of the injury is to be assessed. Proper examination and documentation of the wound may reveal the nature of the wounding object, the direction of the force applied, the approximate age of the wound, the character and manner of the injury, etc. A careful search should be made for wounds in concealed parts. Laboratory investigations are recommended, and treatment prescribed should be noted. When a victim of suicide, homicide, or accident dies in the hospital, the medical officer should report it to the police without delay. In civil cases, the medical officer is entitled to charge a reasonable fee. And in criminal cases, permission of government is required to give evidence for the defense. So in civil cases, if the medical officer is called upon to give evidence, he can charge a reasonable fee. And when a dead body is brought to the hospital, we should not examine the injuries. These are some points we have to remember while filling up a wound certificate or injury certificate. Now, about a model of injury certificate. We have to write the medical legal case number here, then the investigating officer and name and address. Your letter number dated in relation to crime, mention the section of CRPC or IPC. I have honor to forward herewith the result of my examination of son, daughter, wife, or sex, resident of police station, Tehsil district. Brought to hospital on which day at time, patient examined on date and time. Consent for examination: if the patient is less than 12, consent from the guardian is taken. When the questions asked and the reply is given, signature of or left thumb impression of the person and two marks of identification. And brought and identified by the police constable, his number, name, number, and which police station. The patient was examined and treated in outpatient department basis, or was admitted on and discharged on the date. The history of the incident as given by the injured person, and the general examination like general condition, system examination, signs of intoxication, examination of clothes, etc. Then the examination of injuries in particular, you have to serial number the injuries. We have to write the nature of injuries, whether it is abrasion, contusion, laceration, incised, stab, or firearm. The size and shape of injury, we have to measure it with the measuring tape and write the shape. Then site on body, we have to give the exact anatomical location with respect to any point. Then whether the injury is simple or grievous, the kind of weapon that caused the injury, whether it is hard and blunt, sharp edged, sharp pointed firearm, etc., and whether the weapon is a dangerous weapon or not, and an approximate age of injury is to be written. Then the remarks like painful, color, bleeding, foreign body, surgery done, direction, suicidal or homicidal, antemortem or postmortem, injury causing death, etc., should be written. And lastly, the X-ray number, date, and findings. And after that, we have to write about our opinion. We should put the date, place, and time, the signature, name, and designation of the doctor and the office seat. This is the model injury report that is to be given in case of medical legal injuries. And we are coming to the end of this session. In this session, we dealt about the duties of a registered medical practitioner in case of injuries, medical legal injuries, and how to write a injury report.